Live from ABC7, this is Eyewitness News in high definition.
Celiac disease, a digestive disorder, is one of the most undetected diseases in America, affecting one out of every 130 people. While there is no cure, following a strict gluten-free diet allows those afflicted to live a normal life.
But is omitting gluten for everyone? Food coach Lori Corbin reports on who should and who shouldn't be living gluten-free.
I'd like to order one of your gluten-free churros, but I really need to make sure it's gluten-free.
At Churros in Santa Monica, dietitian Evelyn Triboli is scrutinizing the food at a new bakery that sells Spanish churros, not just because she's interested in health, but because her son Connor has celiac disease.
Celiac disease is an autoimmune disorder in which you react to gluten, and gluten's a protein that's found in wheat, rye, oats, and barley.
Those are grains that are typically easy to recognize, yet from licorice, soy sauce, cereal to soup, gluten is in all kinds of foods under many different names. And those who have celiac disease suffer from multi-symptom, multi-system disorders, especially gastrointestinal.
It's like eating glass. It just shaves off all your villi, and so then you get all kinds of stomach problems, pains and aches, but more importantly, there's really horrible diseases that are associated with it.
A blood test and perhaps a small intestinal biopsy will determine the diagnosis. Having celiac disease means a lifelong lesson of following a gluten-free diet, which is challenging. But with supplementation, they can live a normal, healthy life, especially with the inception of all the new products.
There's breads, there's pizza, there's even gluten-free beer.
Actually, gluten-free food is one of the fastest-growing trends at the market. Trader Joe's, Whole Foods, and regular groceries now offer many good-tasting options for those who need them.
Those who feel they're intolerant of gluten may feel better when they omit it from their diet, but unless they've been tested and know for sure, there's good reason why these foods should be kept in the diet.
So you're not going to get folic acid in there, you're not going to get thiamine, iron, or niacin. Keep in mind, if you're going on a gluten-free diet, this is a diet that's typically low in fiber, and it's not enriched in the B vitamins that you get in other kinds of foods.
And gluten-free products also cost more. So Triboli recommends see a physician first before living a gluten-free life. Lori Corbin, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.
From ABC 7.